Our next speaker is Sumita Thapar, a media and advocacy professional who is a media communication specialist as well. Over to you, Sumita, now.
Thank you very much, Shobhaji. Thank you so much, Bobby. Such an honor and a privilege, and so inspiring to be here with all of you all. Really, it's been, you know, like 2 days, two and a half, 2 days plus today of so much information, so much sharing, and I'm really happy to be with everyone. So I'm actually just going to be, you know, sharing some, clues and tips on using social media for engagement. And this is, you know, based on some of the work that, you know, I have done over the last couple of years. And it's just like some broad brush strokes of, you know, how we can use various social media handles for the kind of work that we do to advance discourse. So the first thing that came to my mind is that, you know, it's really important to choose the media handles that we want to invest in. So, you know, sometimes we think that, you know, we should be on every social media handle because it's free. So how does it matter? But, you know, the thing is that when we manage a social media handle, then it requires a lot of time and input and resource. So, you know, all of that is an investment that we are making. So what I have found really effective for myself based on, you know, the base kind of work that I have done is that, you know, when we start, we can be on all, and then we see and figure out for ourselves which one works best for what situation. So for example, these days I manage the SBCC Alliance. SBCC is the Social and Behavior Change Communication Alliance that is hosted by the C40 section of UNICEF India. And over the last couple of months, I found that Twitter works the best for us. So there's a Facebook page as well, and there's also an Insta, but in this work, to interact with other people to who work in the same area, it's Twitter that has worked best for us. But some time back, I was, you know, helping a craft store, promote some of their products and processes, you know, some of the cultural performances. And for that, obviously, I mean, Insta worked best. So, you know, based on the work that we are doing, you know, we need to just figure out which one needs the maximum investment. Because the thing is that it's really important that whatever we choose to be on, it is, you know, you have to be consistent in your engagement on that. And you can figure out for yourself what that consistency should be. So say at the SBCC Alliance, we have agreed that, you know, all 5 working days of the week, we need to engage at least once a day. So some years ago, I was, you know, part of the Key Correspondence social media handle that is hosted by HIV/AIDS Alliance in Brighton. And there, you know, all 5 days of the week, every hour we were tweeting. So which meant that, you know, somebody curated the day's tweets. So from a 9 a.m. to a 4 p.m., that every hour a tweet is going out. And we could schedule the tweets. So, and we found that, you know, since a lot of people who are scheduling tweets are doing it to the hour, it makes sense to just maybe do it, say, 4 minutes past the hour. So that way, there is a constant engagement. You are ensuring that, you know, your social media handle has a constant engagement. But you know, you can do it at one go, and you can come back to it and respond and engage when you have the time, rather than, you know, just doing that all day, because then otherwise no other work gets done. So you can, in that way, prevent from being distracted yourself. The other thing I find is that, you know, this whole digital ecosystem, I mean, there are certain values around it. And it's important that, you know, in order to make the most of this space, we, you know, understand those values and we embrace them fully. So for example, it's democratic, it's non-hierarchical, you know, it's about sharing, it's about promoting, it's about working together, collaborating, those kind of ideas. So, you know, you can be on your social media handle and do your own thing. And yet it's also important that you make sure that you are also collaborating, promoting, liking, retweeting what other people in your network are doing. Because then in a way you do that and then they do it for you. So therefore then, you know, we are helping each other and expanding our networks, you know, making connections happen. So yeah, it's like the whole ecosystem is like an ocean. So how can we navigate it best in order to swim, in order to dive deep, in order to advance the work that we are doing, to create new connections, to create more conversations. So it's really important that, you know, to be on a social media handle and to ensure that we are amplifying the work that our partners, that other people around us working on similar issues are doing for mutual benefit. So it's a partnership, it's a collaboration, and everyone benefits. That is the idea behind it. And, you know, as like, you know, I manage the SBCC Alliance social media handle. So then, you know, it becomes my responsibility and my mandate to also ensure that, you know, the partner's work gets amplified, our own team members' work. So if, you know, one of our own team members has put something, then, you know, that, you know, if I share and I retweet, then that person also gets, you know, that wide audience that the Alliance handle has. So I find that to be very useful and very effective. We found that visuals are crucial when we're looking at social media content. And I mean, research has also shown that across that, you know, all of us are most of the time, you know, looking at content on our phone, or even if you're using a desktop or a laptop, we are scrolling faster than we are reading. So which means that if you really want to catch people's attention, a visual really, really helps. It could be a video, it could be an image, it could be an infographic, it could be a photograph. But visuals are really important to hold people's attention. So it's important to invest in that. So which means that, you know, whether it's a Facebook post or a Twitter or Insta, of course, is, you know, it drives on visual content. But even for the rest, that we make sure that there is enough, you know, good visual content that we can share, because that makes it even more likely that your content will be noticed. And also because, you know, when one is scrolling, then it's very easy to stop and pause at something that interests you. So that way, it's easier to catch attention of people who you want should read what you're saying. So yes, good visual content, good photographs, good images, good videos, really, really important. A lot of us are now using social media for events, and I think that's really, really very, very beneficial and very, very effective, whether it's Facebook Live or Insta, you know, all of these mediums that we are using to do events. I found that really effective, and also to promote events. So if you're doing a real event or a webinar, to use Twitter to promote, you know, that it's happening in a couple of days, you can register here, or even, you know, it's happening in a day, or that is happening right now. So that really helps. And yet again, I also found that, you know, sometimes it's important to see, will a live tweeting an event work better, or would it be better to create a thread? So for example, there was a fireside chat that I was supposed to live tweet on a late Friday evening here for us. So it occurred to me that, you know, it's unlikely that if I'm live tweeting, it's going to bring in more audience. So instead then, you know, I decided that I'm going to do a tweet thread. So maybe just, you know, put together a thread of 10 tweets, and that way it can be more considered. It can be more contemplative. I can, you know, add the hashtags and tag the people. So, and then I decided to do that. So, you know, it's up to us to figure out how best to use social media to promote events, to document events. And that's really, really useful. So, for example, if someone has missed the event, just looking at those 10 tweets will give some indication of this is what happened. And then if that person is interested, they can always, you know, go back and look at the recording. You know, whenever, you know, we are tweeting, and, you know, we always kind of make sure that, you know, we tag people, we add hashtags, and that is so that, you know, if you're tagging people, then, you know, other people get to know whom to follow and how to find those people. And, you know, when you add a hashtag, then it, you are more easily found. So if people are searching for specific conversations, it will be easier for them to find you. So it really helps to tag people, to add hashtags, so that then it is adding to a body of knowledge and you know, a body of work that we are all working together, doing together. And that takes me to the next point, which is, you know, to be part of knowledge creation. So as people who are, using social media and managing social media handles, one thing is that we're liking and retweeting and sharing. And that, of course, is great. But then it's also important, I feel, that, to be seen as creators of knowledge, brokers of knowledge. So which means then to ensure that in the content that we put out, are we linking to maybe new stories that we have done, and maybe it can link it to something that has come on a website, or is it linking up to new research, new findings, human interest stories, stories from the field, photos from the field? It's important that we are not just, swimming out there, but ensuring that we are adding to knowledge on the issues that we work in. And that is how, we can advance discourse on that. So these are just a couple of thoughts and ideas that I found really useful and effective in, handling and engaging with social media. To constantly ask ourselves, how am I contributing to the discourse and what I can do best to advance the discourse better? How can I help other people working on similar issues to amplify their voice? Also to be current and newsy and contemporary, so which is why we use all anniversaries. So if this is 16 days of days dedicated to looking at issues of violence, if it is a all the different anniversaries and days, to make sure that you're using those days to commemorate, to talk about issues, and that way then to be part of a larger conversation, so that we can together work and partner and collaborate to advance discourse on issues. So that is basically about it that I have, and I'm really happy to take any questions, comments.
Thank you very much, Submita. Thank you very much for this very informative and enriching sharing which you have done around social media engagement. I am sure all of us have learned a lot, many new things from you today also. So thank you very much. And we have a good comment from Yashoda Kura, and she says, thank you for an excellent session. Toolkits are very important how to address gender sensitive issues, which are very often not seen. This has been a very much needed training, and often such sessions are required to refresh our knowledge on how to show empathy, be non-discriminative, be equal and non-judgmental, and survivor-centric approaches. Now, if there are any more comments and questions, participants, please type them in the chat box and we will take them up. We are running short of time, but time is sometimes a culprit which we have to deal with. Nahid Khalid wants to know tips to use social media in sexual and gender-based violent questions. Please share. Do we face trolls or attacks or profiling, the risk to person, if we share such news?
Sorry, I don't
understand. When we are sharing news on gender-based violence, gender and sexual and gender-based violence, then there could be trolls there, and how to manage such news on social media?
I really haven't done it. So, I am based on, Bobby just did, a couple of minutes ago, I would just say the same principles would apply. So, which means do no harm, play as safe as possible, protect identity. So the general rules of what applies to media should also apply here. I mean, that would, and it's also, I think, better to err on this side. So, protect identity, do no harm. So that's what, I would say. I don't really have, specific for this, because I haven't really worked on it. But broadly speaking, this is how I would do it. And
Okay. Kalyani Thapa wants to know how important are captions when sharing pictures on social media platforms?
I think they're really important. Very, very important. In fact, we give a lot of attention to that. So, you know, in fact, you know, in some organizations, we even have like really full guidelines on how to caption. So which means that, you know, maybe it's you want to say the name of the village, the district, the town, the locality, when it was done, you know, so whether it's October or November 2021, 2020. So and describing in a line or two lines what is happening. So and also to give due credit to the photographer, to the organization who has, you know, given that picture. So I would think that it's really, really very important, and we must make sure that all of that information comes in.
Okay, thank you. Varuni from Thailand wants to know, in crisis or emergency help appeals, what social media would work best?
Sorry, I really haven't worked on it. I wouldn't be able to answer.
Yes. Maybe Bobby, can you chip in there in case of crisis? Because we are talking of crisis situations. So.
Yeah, thanks. Actually, I will just echo what the Sumita said. And Varuni, probably the answer lies with you and your community of what works in specific situations in your community. What kind of media will be the best for people you are trying to seek attention from? So is it government, or is it, do they use Twitter? Do they use, like in Thailand, probably they use Line a lot, or other platforms, language, for example. So if I have to do it, I probably might, if I have to do it, I'm currently in Lucknow. So I will probably tweet and maybe in Hindi, if I have to attract attention of my local authorities or tag them. As Sumita had so rightly pointed out, find out the right handles if we are using Twitter, if it is relevant, if it is appropriate. But actually the answer lies, probably you have to find the answer. You have to find the right platform, right approach, right, how to tag, etc. might differ from platform to platform. Maybe nothing of this may work, and you may have to have a different kind of approach given the context and situations. So yeah, thanks a lot for raising that point though. Very important one. Because we need to go for the best possible option on how to get attention in emergency and crisis situations to get help.
Yes. Bobby, would you respond to Mansur Dimi's a question also on how to schedule posts on social media?
Yes, thanks a lot for asking this, as Sumita had so rightly pointed out too. So actually I was trying to, I'll just share my screen. Can you all see my screen? Is that open?
No.
Hello? No.
No.
Okay. Not yet, Bobby. Yeah, we can see. Now.
All right. So this is my Twitter. So for example, if I tweet something here, you will find this box. Can you all see this box? This box?
Yeah.
So if you click on this box, you will find that it will, there a schedule option will come up in Twitter. And in my experience, you can schedule as many tweets as possible for free. This, you can select the month, you can select the day, you can select the time zone, and schedule it. The other option which I would like to introduce is Hootsuite. Hootsuite, you can have a free trial too. I have not used it since 2-3 years. But I have used it before 2-3 years a lot. Before 2-3 years, there were free packages also, but there were limitations that how number of tweets which you can, Facebook posts or LinkedIn, etc. But right now I'm not very sure how it works, but it is really a great platform anyways, not just for scheduling, but also for monitoring hashtags or Twitter handles. Buffer is another one which we daily use. Shobha and I have been using it since several years with Inish. The Key Correspondence Program of International HIV/AIDS Alliance, which Sumita mentioned, was founded by Tim France of Inish Communication in late 90s. So Buffer is definitely another good one. Again, free, there are free plans, and free plans may have some limitations. But if you are trying to schedule things on Twitter, I think Twitter's inbuilt scheduling function, which you can use probably. I think it only works with if you use a computer, but maybe they have opened it via phone too. I'm not very aware of that part, but on a computer, it definitely works. So that works very well too. And there are, again, friends, there are many more tools as well. So we auto schedule posts on social media. So explore, you know, with your communities on what works best in your setting. Yes.
And there are some comments from Paolo, who says that social media functions vary. As now, Twitter, if you want your message across fast, Instagram, if you want to share photos, LinkedIn for job opportunities, etc.
Yeah.
Yes, and Ekta Vivek shares her experience that Twitter works best for emergencies, but we have used Facebook extensively as well during the second wave.
Right. And just quickly bore you with a very small story, you know, and I could be wrong, so please correct me. But if I remember correctly, and if my memory is helping me here, probably Twitter, you know, Twitter people who founded Twitter, who were running Twitter in early days, they did not think that Twitter will work the way it is we are using it. So in San Francisco or California, someplace, there was some crisis situations, I think, and people started using Twitter as a tool to alert what's happening. And that's how the whole new dimension of how users are going to use Twitter was, you know, became so popular. But I could be very wrong, but you are very right. Great tips. Yeah.
So thank you. And the conversation does not end, although the session ends, but the conversation and dialogue continues. And we come to the end of this training session. And in these 3 days, we have heard from experts about the various global treaties and conventions that our countries have promised to implement to achieve gender justice, as well as where countries stand in terms of achieving these goals. We have also discussed how gender justice advocates can strengthen their collaboration with media for increasing sensitive and rights-based sustained coverage, and how media can play a very, very important and significant role in this whole ongoing process. I'm sure this has equipped us better and honed our skills to work in a coordinated manner for dismantling patriarchy and advancing gender equality. My sincere thanks to all the participants and resource persons. Special thanks to Evelyn Gomez and her team from Arrow for making this training happen. But just a moment before we leave, let us once again create a Zoom storm. Please try, each one of you, I would request each one of the participants to please type briefly one take-home message from these 3 days of training. And your time begins now. So I want the chat box to be stormed now. The storm is building up, yes.
Excuse me. Hello.
Yes, hello.
Yes, Shobha, actually, I'm visually impaired. And, you know, when I type on my screen with my hands, you know, it's very slow. So can I just...
Yes, please speak out. Bobby will type it out.
Okay.
Yes, please speak.
The sessions went very excellent because we've had clear understanding about how transparent are these conventions.
Yes.
Discussed.
Okay. Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Yeah. Thanks.
Thank you very much. Thank you. So thank you for that. And now, namaste. Till we meet again, please stay safe, stay healthy, and stay empowered, because that is what has been the take-home message for me. Thank you very much.
Yes, thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you, everyone. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hoping
to engage
again.
Thank you, ma'am.
Like, yes. Thank you, Dr. Thank you, my friend. Thank you, Dr. P.S. Sharma. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you, and bye,
everyone. Yes, sir. Thanks to Ms. Shobha Shukla and Bobby Ramakant, because you guys have actually made this 3 days very interactive, and you guys have actually made it successful. Thank you so much.
No, sorry.
Special thanks to.
I beg
thank
to
you.
Differ.
I, really, beg, I agree.
I beg to differ. I beg to differ. It is only you all who have made it so vibrant and informative and exciting.
Thank yes. you so much.
Thank you.
It's all so bad,
Bobby, thank and all. Us. Thank
yes.
you.
Yes, all of us made this happen. So thanks yes, a lot to everyone. It. Thank yes. you, Rita. Yes. Salutes to you always. Thank you, Sumita. Thank you, everyone.
We need the materials too. Materials.
Yes, all materials, friends, all recordings, all presentations, if experts have shared it with us. Everything, we will send it back to you along with a link to enter your name, check your name for the certificate, which Aero will send it directly to you. Okay. Thank you, everyone, very much.
Thank
have
you.
A, bye. And all the best
bye
for 16 days of activism. Power to you all.
Bye bye, Shubha, Babi.
Bye bye.
Bye bye.
Bye
bye.
Bye bye. Bye ma'am. Thank you so much. Thank you, ma'am.
Bye.
Thank you. Bye bye. Take care.
Bye everyone.